So I am now 98 kilometers behind Daringbadi.
Oh my god, shit! What is this? I am doomed.
Hello and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So as you're already aware that today is the day one or the first episode of my Rourkela to Daringbadi trip. So today I'll be traveling from Rourkela to Daringbadi. So that is how the plan is for today.
So I know I'm already very late today, but the delay is due to certain unavoidable circumstances. The time Google Maps shows is about 9 hours and 2 minutes to reach Daringbadi. If I calculate from now, then I would reach Daringbadi by 7 PM. I wanted to reach there before the sunset, but I think that won't happen today. We'll get to ride in the night today. So I had two options to reach Daringbadi. The first option is via Fatlazer, Rajamunda, Barkot, Deogarh, Redakhol. So my initial choice was the same route only, but later on I decided to take the second route, which is through Biju Expressway via Sambalpur, Sonpur, Kalahandi and then Daringbadi. So I'm taking the second route with the hope that the road condition will be better. I have not decided yet, but I'm thinking while returning I'll come by the first route. This is the first longest ride of 2023 and I'm pretty excited. Daringbadi, it was in my mind since a very long time actually. I was planning it last year, but due to some reason could not make it. This year I said anyhow I have to go, so today I am on my way. We are approaching Jharsuguda. My estimated arrival at Sambalpur would be around 1 o'clock. Genius. Long trailer. So here comes the bridge over River Ib, which is a tributary of Mahanadi. There is also a place called Ib on the banks of the river. And it is one such place which has the shortest name ever in the world. I have covered this highway a lot of times. I traveled to Sambalpur twice, and while returning from Bangalore to Rourkela, I covered this highway. So if you are my regular viewer, then this route is familiar to you. This is JSW. This is the company who is sponsoring the Men's Hockey World Cup 2023. Jindal Steel. Aditya Aluminium, there is a lot of pollution here. This is an industrialized area, so that's why the pollution. This place is Rengali. In Odia we call it Rengali. Sambalpur 23. Go, 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 go. Anthapalli, which is Sambalpur. So you are officially welcome to Sambalpur. Deogarh left, Burla right, Deogarh right. Biju Expressway ends here. Mumbai is 1425 kilometers, Sambalpur 5, Kolkata 566. So this highway right in front of me is the Kolkata Mumbai highway, which you saw in the Kevinger vlog. Left is Kolkata, right is Mumbai. Now we officially enter Sambalpur. That was Anthapalli Chowk, where I took the halt. Budha Raja Temple on the right hand side on top of the hill.
So this is my bike and I'm at I Love Sambalpur point. I'll take a small break here and then I'll proceed towards Sonepur.
Yes, Sonepur, right, correct. I might sound excited, but yes, I was looking for this. This is the Huma temple route. I came by this route, yes. Huma temple 22, Sonepur 80, Valangir 130. The last time when I came to Huma temple, the driver was saying that this road goes to Sonepur. Superb visit again, thank you. Sonepur 33, okay. The time is now 2:33, Sonepur is 33 kilometers more. So I had taken one break here. I had some chocolate and water. Sonepur right lane, I had to take right. Sonepur Hikkodi Bijaipur. Fine. Nice. It's good that the board was there, otherwise I could have gone somewhere else. Aha! This is Mahanadi. Water is not there, but this is the Mahanadi riverbed. As per the map, I have to cross two bridges. I think this road leads to one. Then going ahead, I may find one more. Left and right, I think I have to go left. This is a dried up river. No water. Anyways, we have to cross Mahanadi because you have to go to the other side of the river. If you go via both, then you come across Mahanadi bridge again. This is Sonepur. Okay, I see this is a signal. Do I go straight or I take a turn? Let me check. I have to go straight, okay. So I will take this right and after the bridge, one more right. Left will take to both. Got it. Kontamal, I have to go both Bhuneshwar. Okay, fine. Bhuneshwar 280, both 49. So I think the bridge is right ahead of us. This is Mahanadi bridge. That side is both. Kontamal right, both straight, Bhuneshwar straight. Okay. I have to take right. Varampur 228, Daringbadi 98. Oh, bhai saab. Finally, I saw Daringbadi, but 98 kilometers. Oh, what is this? This is beautiful.
Now 98 kilometers behind Daringbadi and I have taken a halt at this beautiful place.
I hope you loved the drone shots. And I met two wonderful people here who are local to this place, and they said that it will take me around 2 hours more to reach Daringbadi. And this is a really beautiful and serene place. I hope you loved the drone shot already. So now let's not waste time, and along with this beautiful view which is right in front of you, let's proceed with our journey. Welcome to Ballyguda Forest Range. So from here Ballyguda Forest Range starts. I think once this forest ends, we will enter Ballyguda. 20-25 kilometers from there, I think it's Daringbadi. I assume I have to cover a ghat section because this road is going up. Yes, it is gonna be a ghat section. Traveling here in the night, but the night experience is also good. I expect no animals come in front of me. Apart from that, everything is good. If an elephant or a tiger or a bear comes, then it's a problem. This will be beautiful during the daytime. So these are all a section of the Eastern Ghats range. If you want more such views of Eastern Ghats, then you can follow my ride from Bangalore to Rourkela. I have covered a lot of places. Taptamani, Jirang, Kalinga Ghat, all are a part of the Eastern Ghats. Fulbani Ghat as well. Talking about Fulbani Ghat, I wanted to avoid Fulbani Ghat during the night. Now I am covering this ghat during the night. This is Kalahandi forest range. Oh, I can listen to the various insects making sounds in the dark. If I stop revving, I can listen to the sounds. See if you can hear. And there is one thing which is bit scary, not much. Anyways, I am not afraid of anything, but still, I am the only person on this road. There is nobody else. So if I land in any trouble, I am on my own. Nobody is there to help me. So I'm going up and up and up, and eventually the temperature will go down and down and down. I am alone in this ghat section. Nobody else here. It is pretty scary. Even though I'm not afraid of it, just saying somebody's coming. Yes, my guess was correct. I saw the second vehicle on this ghat. Oh my god, shit! Oh god, what is this? I'm doomed. I didn't expect these kind of roads. My fuel level is up by 3 bars. And I didn't expect this thing here. This should not be the road condition. I avoid these kind of roads during the daytime. And I'm traveling here in the night. Awesome, brilliant. Now it's 6:25. I think my estimated arrival would be 9 o'clock or something because of these roads. Now I think I should have gone by the Fulbani Ghat. Okay, better roads? No. Fulbani Ghat is better actually. Better means it's awesome, brilliant. You can check out my last day's ride from Bangalore to Rourkela, where I covered Barampur to Rourkela. The Fulbani Ghat section was brilliant roads. Oh, it's my bike is skidding now. Oh my god, I had to travel in that pathetic road for 1 hour. My GoPro was turned off due to low battery. I didn't even get a chance to replace it, because if I turn off my bike, it's completely dark. if I turn keep my bike on, I'm running out of fuel now. So I didn't have any option. I had to cover that road. 1 hour of pathetic road condition. I'm the only one in that road. Nobody else was there. Then finally, after 1 hour, I got this road. So now I'm 73 kilometers behind Daringbadi, which will take me around another 1.5 hours to reach. Now it's 7:15. Clearly, I'll reach by 9 o'clock. I can say that. I was thinking of returning by this route, but no, now I've dropped the idea. I'll go by Fulbani route. This route, thanks, but no thanks. Now my fuel level has dropped to 2 bars and I need to find the nearest fueling station. I think Baliguda is now 24 or 23 kilometers more. So now my bike is on neutral and I'm going at a speed of around 55 kilometers an hour. Barakhama, this is what I read. At least this place has electricity. After that bad roads and before I started again, I came across a village which didn't had electricity. This is year 2023 and people are still living in darkness. I think this is a lake or pond, something, I don't know what it is. I saw the light reflecting on the water. Some people call this place as Daringbadi. It's not Daringbadi, it's Daringbadi. There was a British officer by the name Daring. After his name, this place has been named Daringbadi. In Odia, Badi means house. Daringbadi was the officer's favorite hill station and he even had a house there. So in his honor, this place is named as Daringbadi. I don't know why we are honoring Britishers so much. Maybe he would be a good officer. I don't know. Ye kya hai? Ye kya hai? So many mavishis here. Kawo kawo. Holy cow, what are you doing in the dark now? It's pretty cold out here and I'm getting the cold breeze on my face because I cannot put down my tinted visor. Palliguda notified area welcomes you. Area council, okay. So finally I've reached Palliguda. 73 minus 26. If I don't get a petrol pump, I am doomed. My fuel level is still 2 bars. I need a refueling station. Things are brighter ahead. Now it feels good. Actually, it feels good. Barampur 165. Daringbadi 50. Daringbadi 50. I'll take a break. Nice. It's a nice, beautiful temple. Petrol pump? Oh, wow, wonderful. Very good. Beautiful. Sabas. Let's get rid of one problem, the petrol problem. So finally, I got my bike refueled. So this road has full lighting. It's good. Nice. Happy journey, Baliguda Gram Panchayat, notified area council. Thank you. I'm not reaching by 9 o'clock because I took good breaks here. Now the arrival time is pushed to 9:30. My biggest problem is getting food. I'm very hungry and if I don't get food, then it's gonna be a problem. Daringbadi 39. Oh, great. Out of 50, I covered 11. 39. Awesome. I think that is the sign board for Daringbadi. What is this? No, I cannot take risk. Let me go back and reconfirm. Can you see it? Complete dark. Only my light is lighting up this place. Some vehicle is coming behind me. Cross the road. Okay, so what is written? Baliguda 10, Titlagad 142, Khariyar 190. Okay, now let the vehicle go. I'll take a U-turn and I'll check the board again. You might have seen it because it's recorded, but I didn't see it properly. I need to see that. It's complete dark. Oh, straight is Fulbani, Daringbadi right. Dude, oh my god, I just got saved. Oh God. Brahmapur Ballyguda. I just got saved or else gone case. I was taking the Phulbani route. Man, I'm glad I took the U-turn. I'm glad. I was thinking, okay, this is the right route only. I'm only overthinking. Dude. Oh my God. Oh my God. 39 kilometers are left. I would have screwed myself very badly. This is a ghat section and it was pretty obvious because to reach a hill station you have to climb the hill. Lover's Point. Okay, I'm at Lover's Point means Daringbadi is not far. This road goes somewhere. I don't know where. Emu Birds Park. Okay, yes. I can see lights over there. I think that is Daringbadi. What else it can be? The time is now 9:16. I have not yet reached Daringbadi. Eco Retreat Odisha 1 kilometer Daringbadi. Okay. Whoa, this is a beautiful ghat section. I mean valley. This is a beautiful valley. I can see from here. From the lights they have put up. In the daytime it will be, oh my God, I am excited for tomorrow. They have selected a nice place. Oh, this car is blinding me. Go. This is Odisha Eco Retreat Daringbadi. I'll visit this place tomorrow. Hillview Park, okay, Hillview Park. This route has a lot of places. I'll cover this route tomorrow. Remaining places day after tomorrow. Daringbadi, 2 kilometers, okay. So the time now is 9:31 and I am at Daringbadi. I just need to find my hotel. Hotel Hilltop, okay. Roadside parking, no roadside parking. Hotel, I need a hotel with proper parking, at least compound fenced parking. Hotel Gaura, do you have parking, Mr. Gaura? No, Mr. Gaura has roadside parking, which I don't want. Turmeric Hotel, yes. Okay, how to go inside? I found my hotel finally. Achha, kya board laga hai? Turmeric Hotel, way too. Oh God, kahan ghusa ke bana hotel, aur jagah nahi mila isko banane ke liye. अच्छा ये रहा अभी रोड साइड पार्किंग बट थोड़ा अंदर है. अच्छा ये देखा था मैंने भाई रूम अच्छी.
So finally I have reached my hotel at Daringbadi. This is Turmeric Hotel. Now I'll go to my room and freshen up and have my dinner and then go to sleep because I have planned for an exciting day tomorrow. So I'll see you tomorrow in my YouTube channel next week. Till then, take care, stay safe, and goodbye.